And this is the North Pole. And when it's Christmas time at the North Pole, everybody wears the hat. It's part of the seasonal costume.
No, I understand that. And on the elves, I can see it. The elves look cute in the hats. They look downright elfish. But I'm your chief of staff. I'm supposed to command respect. How can I get any respect when I'm wearing a silly hat? Grown-up people who wear the hat look like buffoons.
I wear the hat.
And you look terrific in the hat. You are the hat. When people think of the hat, they think of you. But me, when I put it on, I look like a garden gnome. I look like I should be standing watch over your petunias.
Al, how long have you worked here?
58 years.
And every year we have the same discussion.
And isn't it getting a little bit tiresome?
It certainly is. Now put the hat on.
Santa.
Al, put on the hat.
All right, you're the boss, but it's going to look silly. Well, what do you think?
Take it off. You look silly.
Thank you. You do that every year just to get a good laugh, don't you?
Yes, I do. And it cracks me up every time. All right, let's get down to business. What does my schedule look like today?
Well, Santa, it's a busy one. Right after breakfast, you have a meeting with the sleigh salesman.
Sleigh salesman?
Yes, I told you about it last week. He's got a new sleigh he wants you to try out.
Well, what's wrong with the sleigh I've got?
Santa, come on. That thing was built during the Renaissance. It's 500 years old.
Well, I think it's still got a lot of miles left on it.
A lot of miles? Santa, you've driven that thing into the ground. Plus, I don't think the sleigh or the reindeer are meeting today's emission standards.
Well, I think the sleigh is fine.
Well, will you at least speak with the man? I mean, he's come all the way up here from Detroit.
All right, if he's come all this way, I'll meet with him as a courtesy.
Thank you. Now, at next is 10 o'clock. You'll be listening to the elves singing to hear how they're doing.
Then how are they doing?
Well, word on the street isn't good, Santa. Ever since the choir master retired, they've been rehearsing on their own. And I understand that the rest of the staff has taken to wearing earmuffs whenever they pass the rehearsal hall.
Well, of course they're wearing earmuffs. It's cold outside.
Yes, I'm sure that's it. Now, at 10:30, it'll be your morning snack. At 11 o'clock, brunch. At 12 o'clock, it's lunch. Now, at 12:30 to 1, I've scheduled some indigestion. And later in the afternoon, you'll be parachuting into the, at 2 o'clock, parachuting into the West Edmonton Mall. That'll be the south entrance. And please be careful this time. You remember last Christmas you misjudged your approach and landed on that sausage vendor's cart?
I didn't misjudge my approach. I was hungry.
Yeah, well, just land where they ask you to, and we'll order in some ribs. Now, at 3:30, you have a meeting in Paris with the Ballanger twins.
Jacques and Maurice?
Yes, they want to speak to you about the lumps of coal you left in their stockings last year. Apparently, they've been good all year, and they wanted to make sure you were aware of that.
Oh, I know they've been good. I've been watching, and I've been very impressed.
Yeah, well, personally, I think you should leave them the call again this year, just to make sure they get the message.
Well, that's why I'm Santa Claus, and you're not. Well, what's next?
Well, from Paris, it's off to Thailand.
Oh, I love Thai food.
Uh-huh. Then to Switzerland.
Mmm, schnitzel.
Yeah, and then back here to spend some time in the workshop.
Well, that sounds like another full day.
Santa's office, Al Gladstone speaking. You'd like to speak to Santa Claus. Yeah, you and a billion others just like you. Well, I'm sorry, he's at a meeting right now.
Al?
No, I'm sorry, he can't be disturbed. Yes, that's right. Well, I'll tell him you called, but I wouldn't count on him getting back to you anytime soon. Okay, bye-bye. Call the wife when you get a chance. I spoke to the Tooth Fairy yesterday. Yes, she's trying to set up a tour for the speaking tour for the two of you for next summer in South America. But this is the funny part. She wants top billing. Yeah, she wants to call it the Tooth Fairy and Santa Claus Get Silly and Chilly Tour. So I said to her, Tooth, I says, come on. You see maybe 8 million people in a year. Santa does the whole world in just one night. No way you should get top billing. So she says she's going to think about it and have her people get back to me. Yeah, like the Tooth Fairy needs people.
Well, you look after that for me, Al. That's why I hired you.
No problem. Listen, Santa, can I ask a tiny favor of you?
Oh, certainly. What is it?
I'd like to hitch a ride with you on Christmas Eve. I need a lift to the Cayman Islands. Spending Christmas this year.
All right. You're spending it with friends, relatives?
Nope, just me.
Al, you're not spending Christmas alone again, are you?
Why not? I've done it every other year. Why should this year be any different?
Why? Because Christmas is a time to be shared with loved ones. That's why.
Yeah, well, I don't have any loved ones, Santa. And you know what? That's the way I like it. I'd much rather be relaxing on a beach on Christmas morning than to be opening presents that other people felt they had to buy for me.
Algernon, that is entirely the wrong attitude to take towards Christmas. Christmas is a time of joy, and if I were you, I would appreciate Christmas for the way that it brings people together, for the way it makes each one of us feel towards one another.
Well, that's why I'm Al Gladstone and you're not.
Santa Claus, excuse me for interrupting, but I need to be beating your eardrum.
What was that?
He wants to talk to you.
Certainly. Come right in, Bolsador. What can I do for you?
Well, did you pull hat gag on Al again?
Yes.
And it worked.
Like a charm.
I love that bit.
It's a good one, isn't it?
I'm sorry I missed it.
All right, Bolsador, get on with your business. Santa and I have a schedule to keep here.
Right. Well, I am bringing good news. The North Pole Special just pulled in with rest of toy-making supplies.
Oh, that is good news. Excellent news.
I know. When I heard, I was so happy, I had to pinch my elf to make sure I wasn't dreaming.
Well, you make sure that the supplies get over to the workshop as quickly as possible, Bolsador, and make sure they ship everything we asked for. All of the wood, the wood glue, the nuts and bolts, the doll's eyes, everything.
You got it. I will check, double check, and body check.
There should be a case of stones in there, too. See that it's sent to my cabin, will you?
Okie donkey. What is sconce?
Oh, it's like a big biscuit, and they go great with a cup of tea.
Just go, please, Bolsador.
That's for sure. I am gone before you can say, hit the road, Jack Frost.
All right, Ella. Let's hit off for breakfast, shall we? And we'll stop at the workshop on the way by and let the elves know that the supplies are in.
Oh, Santa, you want me to go with you to the workshop?
Well, what's wrong with the workshop?
Oh, it's those elves. They're so cheerful all the time. And they're always singing and they whistle while they work.
That's the seven dwarves?
Elves, dwarves.
You're coming with me, Al. I think you could use a little cheerfulness. Oh, no, leave the hat. I'll need that again next year.
are you here?
Sewn up, and my Christmas Eve pants need to be pressed as well.
Oh, come on, Santa Claus. What am I, your housekeeper?
Yes, you are.
Oh, right. I'll get right on it.
Thank you. Now, let's see how work is progressing here. Oh, this is nice, very nice indeed.
How are you this morning, Algernon?
Oh, I'm good. Busy.
Uh-huh.
But that's the way I like it, you know. Uh-huh. Gotta keep busy. Otherwise, what is there to do up here? I mean, how many times can you play flashlight tag with Rudolph?
Right.
And how are you doing?
Oh, I'm busy too, you know. Being the North Pole housekeeper is like having a full-time job.
Well, it is your full-time job.
Oh, right. It is. So, are you coming to the Christmas wrap party?
Wrap party?
Yeah, you know, when we wrap up all the Christmas presents on Christmas Eve.
Oh, I don't know, Octavia. I'm going to have a million things to do Christmas Eve. What with that? I'm going to pack up and everything.
Oh, are you going away again this year?
Yes, I am.
Down south?
Well, I would have to, wouldn't I? Well, south is the only direction from here. This is North Pole.
Oh, right. You'd think I'd know that by now. No. So, you won't be coming to the party then?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, that's too bad.
Why?
Well, you're one of the few people up here that I can talk to face to face.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, I talked to the elves for too long and I'm hunched over for a week. Well, I better get over to pick up Santa's coat
sure.
Oh, and a word of warning. Maybe I'll see you at breakfast.
Oh, maybe.
And a word of warning. Watch out for that hat gag, because I think Santa's going to pull it on you again this year.
I'll be ready.
Morning, Octavia.
Morning, Ozadar.
Santa.
Oh, yes, Ozadar.
Santa, we've got a problem at train station.
A problem? What sort of problem? Did they forget the supplies?
Well, no. Supplies are fine. Supplies are in good supply. You don't have to worry, Worth, about that.
Well, what's the problem, then?
Well, now, it's not a big problem. It is nothing to get your blouse in a sheep shank about.
My what?
Your shirt in a knot.
Oh.
Right. It's a smaller problem. Well, not real small. It is somewhere between small and big. Smig, I guess.
Bozadar, get to the point.
Well, I can explain it to you better in your office. Can you meet me there in time it takes to make minute rice?
I beg your pardon?
5 minutes.
Oh, yes, of course. Certainly, Bozadar. We'll be right over.
Good. I see you there in 2 shakes of a Lamborghini.
All right, Alan. Let's go. Now, don't forget to stop for breakfast, everyone. It's the most important meal of the day, you know.
We will, Santa!
Goodbye, now.
Goodbye, Santa! Goodbye, Mr. Flintstone!
Flintstone!
Tries to stop. Rocking around the Christmas tree, let the Christmas spirit ring. Later we'll have some pumpkin pie and we'll do some caroling.
Go in for those resort-type places. I mean, that's not roughing it. When I'm on vacation, I like to get back to the land, back to basics. No, it's just a little grass hut right on the beach. No television, no phone, no bathroom.
No bathroom?
No.
Well, what do you do when you need a bathroom?
Well, there's a resort next door. I use theirs. I go over there if there's something I want to watch on TV.
Or if you need to use the phone.
Yeah.
Santa, are these the pants you wanted ironed?
Yes, those are the ones.
Hello, Algernon.
Octavia. Okay, hi.
So we meet again.
Yes, so we do.
Strange, huh? Sometimes I don't see you for days, and then this morning I see you twice in a matter of a few minutes.
Well.
Do you suppose it's fate, or is it destiny?
Fate is destiny.
It is? Well, shut my mouth.
is the problem I was telling you about. She is a stone's throw away.
She's a what?
A stone's throw away.
I'm sorry, what?
A stowaway.
Oh.
Right. We found her on North Pole Special. She was hiding in Boxcar Willie.
Well now, young lady, the North Pole Special is not a passenger train. It's for supplies only. What's your name?
Kit, what's yours?
Hey, don't be a Weisenheimer.
Never mind, Al, I can handle this. I'm Santa Claus, Kit, and this is Bozidar, Octavia, and Algernon.
What is this? The North Pole or the land of stupid names?
Well, isn't that the pot calling the kettle of fish?
Bozidar, Octavia, you can both go about your work now, please.
Are you sure, Santa? Are you sure you'll be okay here with this one?
I'm sure I'll be fine. Don't worry, Bozidar.
All right. But if she is giving you any trouble, you just call my name, and I'll be there in a hurry. You won't have to worry. Because, baby, there ain't no mountain high enough.
But which kid are you?
What do you mean, which kid?
Well, I have a lot of kids on my list. Thousands, in fact.
I'm Kit Bishop.
The Halifax Kit Bishop or the Annapolis Royal Kit Bishop?
Annapolis Royal.
All right, now we're getting somewhere. And tell me, Kit Bishop, why did you travel all the way up here to the North Pole?
I had to bring you something.
Oh, what's this, a letter?
No, it's a ceiling fan. What does it look like?
Hey, Orphan Annie, save your attitude for your school teachers. This is Santa Claus you're talking to here.
It's all right, Al. It's all right. So, you came all the way up here to deliver a letter, did you?
Yeah.
I see. Are you sure it wasn't because of that quarrel you had with your mother last week?
What quarrel?
Oh, come now, Kit. According to my sources, your mother scolded you last week for doing poorly on your history exam at school. And you said you did poorly because you had too much work to do at home and didn't have time to study. Now, was that you, or was that the Halifax Kit Bishop?
All right, it was me. But I didn't come up here because of that. I just came to deliver the letter.
No. Fine, then. What's in the letter?
I don't know. I didn't write it. It's from my little sister.
Oh, Michelle?
Right. She says she sent you a letter last year, but she doesn't think you got it because you didn't give her what she asked for. So this year, she asked me to hand deliver one to you.
And you did all of this, sneaking onto a train, traveling in a cold boxcar for days, probably going hungry, all for your little sister.
Nah, I didn't go hungry. I found a case of scones on the train.
Oh, come on!
Nevertheless, you did all of this for Michelle.
Well, sure I did. She's a good kid. I do whatever I can for her.
I know you do.
Yeah, and it'd be nice if you did too.
Pardon me?
Don't let her down again like you did last year. Make sure she gets what she wants this time.
Okay, sister, that's it. Hit the road.
Al, no.
Santa, we can't have street urchins coming in here and making demands like that.
I'm not a street urchin.
Yeah, tell it to the Easter Bunny.
Al, before you go throwing Miss Bishop into the snow, let me tell you a little bit about her.
Then can I throw her out?
If, when I'm finished, you still feel she deserves to be thrown out, then by all means, you may.
Good enough. Lay it on me.
Well, her father died when Kit was only 9 years old. Her mother works 12 hours a day making pottery and other craft work, which she sells at the local market to make ends meet. Kit goes to school during the day and works a few nights a week at a clothing store. Well, of course, all the money she makes goes right into the family account to help her mother pay the bills. At home, Kit cooks all of the meals and does the lion's share of the housework. Unfortunately, all of this leaves her very little time to pursue her first love, which is music. Kit would like to be a professional singer and songwriter someday, but with the way things are going right now, she may have to put her dreams on hold so that she can help her family through these difficult times. And there you have it. That is the story of our young kingfisher.
Okay, out you go.
What? That story didn't touch you at all?
Touch me? Are you kidding? Compared to my childhood, that was the feel-good story of the year.
You'll have to excuse Al, Miss Bishop. I'm afraid all these years as my chief of staff have left them a little too businesslike. Now then, let's see what your sister has to say in this letter.
You can throw me out, Gomer.
Oh, I could throw you out all right, Powderpuff.
Yeah? You what, elf army?
I wouldn't need an army. I could toss you like a Greek salad.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, I could drop you like a sack of toys.
Oh, you're lucky you're a girl.
You got that right.
All right, then.
So, what does she want?
Oh, I'm afraid that's privileged information. That's between myself and Michelle.
Yeah, okay, fine. Well, you got the letter, so I'll be going now.
Going where?
Home.
And how do you propose on doing that?
On the train, of course.
Oh, I'm afraid that won't be possible.
What? You're not going to let me ride the train back?
The train's not going back.
It's what?
It's a supply train, and it just delivered our last load of supplies. It won't be going back until production begins again in March.
March?
Nice planning, Einstein.
Well, how am I supposed to get back home? I need to be home in time for Christmas.
I'm sure we'll think of something. Oh, in the meantime, maybe you'd like to join us for breakfast. And then after breakfast, I'll get Al to show you around.
Oh, Santa, don't make me play nursemaid to her.
Hey, I can take care of myself. Don't you worry about that.
Oh, like I'm going to worry about you.
All right, now that's enough of both of you. Al, you'll show Kit around while I meet with the sleigh salesman. Now, let's get some food before I waste away.
That could take a while.
Just get going, would you?
Don't rush me, Wilbur.
I'll rush you all right.
Oh, I don't think so.
Well, think again, Artful Dodger.
Santa, I hope I've been a good girl this year, because I'm asking you for something that is very important. Could you please bring my sister Kit some Christmas spirit? She doesn't seem to have as much fun as Christmas as she used to, and it makes me sad to see her unhappy. Thank you, Santa. I love you. Michelle Bishop.
Elves aren't back from breakfast yet. Let's make this quick before they show up. Now, this is the workshop. This is where all the toys are made. We start production around March, and we go straight through continuously day and night until Christmas Eve.
Day and night? Don't the elves get tired?
Oh, don't worry. We work the elves in three shifts of 8 hours each. What do you think, Santa's going to overwork his elves? How would that look in the press? Besides, they get some nice fringe benefits, like there's very good skiing in the area. They get into movies at children's prices, and they get a day off to celebrate Mickey Rooney's birthday. Now, back through there is the sewing room, the laundry room, and Octavia's quarters. Back that way is the elves' quarters and Bozidar's room.
So, what did you mean back there about your childhood?
What?
Your childhood. You implied that it was rough.
So, what if it was?
Oh, nothing. I was just wondering if it was as rough as mine.
What? Hey, Earth to Major Bishop. Being a kid is rough at the best of times. Every kid has it rough, and everyone for different reasons. So you grew up without a father. I grew up without a mother. So what? There are kids who have both parents, and they still have a rough go of it. Some lack confidence. Some have difficulty making friends. Some can't play sports as good as the others, or have difficulty with their schoolwork, or think they look goofy in their glasses, or can't play, can't swim, or can't ride a bike, and on and on and on. To the rest of us, these seem like small problems, but when it's our problem, it's the biggest problem in the world, and sometimes we think we'll never overcome it, but we always do. So put your violin back in its case, because I can't hear it.
What happened to your mother?
She got sick and never recovered.
Oh.
So my dad raised me, and he did a good job, too. Taught me to be strong. Taught me to make it in the business world.
I really miss my dad, especially around Christmas time.
Yeah, well, my dad wasn't big on the whole Christmas thing. He was a truck driver, and to him, it was just downtime, a time when he didn't make much money.
Oh, hello, Elginog.
Octavia.
Hi, Kit.
Hi.
Do you believe this? Three times.
What?
This is the third time we see each other this morning.
Really? I've seen you twice already this morning.
Well, yes, silly. Once here, and then a few minutes ago in Santa's office.
Oh, right.
He must be setting some kind of record or something.
Yeah, we'll have to get Guinness on the phone.
Who?
Guinness, the people who published the Book of World Records.
There's a Book of World Records?
Yes.
What's it called?
The Guinness Book of World Records.
Well, string my beans. Well, I better get Santa's coat back to him. Maybe I'll see you a little later on. No. I don't think so. That would be four times. That really would be a record, wouldn't it?
Yes, I guess it would.
Well, goodbye.
Yeah, bye. Okay, let's go.
She likes you.
What?
That woman. She likes you. She's got a crush on you.
A crush? Octavia? She does not.
She does. I can tell.
You cannot. How can you tell?
She gets all flustered around you. And she makes small talk so she can be around you for an extra few seconds. No, she's definitely got a crush on you.
Oh, I don't believe that.
Oh, Elginog! I was just wondering, did you happen to see the weather forecast for tonight?
The weather forecast? No, I didn't.
Well, apparently it's going down to minus 55.
Ooh, minus 55. Whoa, heat wave. I better take that extra blanket off my bed.
Oh, Elginog, you're so funny.
Oh, man, you didn't see that?
See what?
Making small talk about the weather? Laughing at your dumb joke when she's caught it bad.
You don't know what you're talking about. And it wasn't a dumb joke.
Oh, it was dumb, all right.
It's been a hard day's life, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's life, and I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I find the things that you do might make me feel all right.
Calm down. Well, as long elves are here, I might as well introduce you. These are the elves. You saw them at breakfast. They were the ones eating shortbread. Elves, this is Kit Bishop.
Hi.
Hello, Kit Bishop.
Yeah, sure, you get her name right.
Oh, there you are, Al. I have been looking for you, high and lowest land.
Well, you found me, Bowser. What is it?
Well, I've got the bad news about scones.
Uh-huh.
They are all gone. Disappear. They vanish into thinning air.
Thin air.
What?
It's thin air.
Oh, must be the altitude.
Well, thanks for telling me, Bozidar.
You are welcome.
All right, you can go. What is it? What's wrong?
Well, I got confession to make.
A confession about what?
Well, I not tell Santa Claus whole truth and nothing but the truth about supplies.
You didn't?
I not want to worry him. He already got too much playing gentle on his mind. I shouldn't even tell you. In fact, I won't. Just forget I threw it up.
Bozidar.
No, I never tell. A team of wild horse flies couldn't tear it out of me.
Bozidar, please.
All right. You are going to get the nasty, I thought. The thing is, we not get all of our supplies like I tell Santa Claus we did.
What do you mean? What didn't we get?
Well, hold on to your hat size. We not get any wood glue.
What?
Not a drop. We order 200 gallons wood glue. We get butkus.
Oh, this is terrible.
It is apostrophe.
Catastrophe.
Is that too?
Oh, my. Well, we've got rocking horses to glue together. Marionettes, hockey sticks, guitars.
Desks, dollhouses, toy boats.
Carousels, scooters.
Can I make a suggestion?
Excuse me, you mind? We're in the middle of a panic attack here.
But it's not that difficult to...
Just let me think, would you? Okay, Bozidar, you did the right thing by not telling Santa. He's got enough to worry about. Now, what we've got to do is come up with a glue substitute.
You can make your own glue.
Look, I'm not going to tell you again. If I want your opinion... What? Make our own glue?
Sure. My mother does it all the time for her crafts.
How? How do you make glue? What do you need?
Well, you need non-fat milk, vinegar, baking soda, hot tap water, and some coffee filters.
That's it? That's all we need?
That's it.
And we can make glue from this?
You sure can.
Well, I'll be my uncle's monkey.
Oh, now there's a charming attitude. I give you a chance to save Christmas for children all over the world, and all you can say is, what's in it for me? $10. Bozidar, loan me $10.
What?
Just until payday. You'll get it back.
Oh, sure, I get it back. Famous last words. I still waiting for $10 you owe me from Stanley Cockbet.
Hey, that goal was offside. No way I'm paying for that.
Well, then that makes you a Welshman.
A Welcher. Thank you. There you go. Now let's go.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Now I don't mean to be playing devil's avocado. But how are we going to make glue without Santa Claus knowing about it?
Oh, yeah, that's right. We'll have to make it somewhere where he won't find out. We'll use your room.
My room?
Yeah, it's perfect. It's next, right next to the workshop, and Santa never goes in there.
All right. But if Santa Claus finds it and is asking how it got there, then I am saying I am clueless.
Good, he'll believe that. Now let's get over to the cafeteria and get the supplies we need. And while we load up, you can write out the formula for us. Let's ride.
Goodbye, Mr. Tombstone.
Hey, you're this close to becoming a charm bracelet, okay?
Thank you, Octavia. Thank you.
Anything wrong, Santa? Well, you look troubled. Is something wrong?
Oh, no. It's just that some children's Christmas lists are harder to fill than others. There are some things you can't put under a tree.
Oh, I'm sure you'll be able to do it, Santa. You always manage somehow.
Oh, I hope so. I certainly hope so. Oh, that reminds me. I haven't seen your Christmas list yet.
Oh, I don't want anything, Santa. I'm fine.
Are you sure?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, come now, Octavia. There must be something I can get for you.
No. Unless you could open a person's eyes.
What's that supposed to be?
Well, there's a certain someone that I kind of like, but he doesn't seem to know I'm alive. I just think it would be nice if he'd notice me, that's all. But that's not the kind of request you would handle, is it?
That does sound more like a job for my friend Cupid.
Right, and you don't want to step on his toes, not with him being armed and all. Well, don't you worry about me this year, Santa. I know you have way more important cases to handle anyway.
They're all important, Octavia, each and every one. That's what makes my job so difficult.
Yeah. Well, I'd better get back to work. I don't want to fall behind. It's not like there's 24 hours in a day to do all this stuff.
Yes, have a nice day, Octavia. Oh, come in.
Santa Claus?
Yes.
Well, of course you're Santa Claus. You're sitting there. You've got the beard, the belly. Who are you going to be? Pippi Longstocking? Come on. Santa, nice to meet you. The name is Lewis Flapdoodle. I'm from the National Sleigh Company. Your buddy Al said that I should be here at 9:30 sharp. I'm not late, am I? Because it says 9:30 on the nose on my watch. And look at that. It's a Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer watch. So when I say it's 9:30 on the nose, I mean it. Anyway, thank you for seeing me this morning, Santa. Can I call you Santa? What do you like, Santa, Chris, Nick, Per Noel? Last guy I knew who used that many names was on the run from John Law, but that's another story. So, what'll it be, Santa?
Santa will be just fine.
Santa it is then, and you can call me Lou. Most folks call me Lucky Lou because I've had an uncommon run of good fortune where sleigh sales are concerned. I don't know what it is, but I always manage to close the deal. And they're honest deals too, Santa. Yes, sir, I'm not a swindler. I'm not a charlatan. I'm not a fraud. Well, you know that. You're the guy who knows if we've been naughty or nice, right? You've seen my work. Besides, do you think I'm going to try and cheat Santa Claus? Not on your life. Mama Flapdoodle didn't raise no fool. Besides, trying to pull the wool over your eyes would be like trying to sneak a butterball turkey past you. It ain't gonna happen, babe. Do you mind if I take my coat off, Santa? Because I work better when I'm unrestricted. Would that be copacetic?
Of course.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. Ah, there. That's better. Ha ha. Oh. There we are. Oh, it's cold up here, isn't it? Well, it is the North Pole. I mean, what's it gonna be? Beach weather? Of course not. You know what it's gonna be. It's gonna be sleigh weather. That's what it's gonna be. And that is why I'm here, Santa. That, my friend, is why I'm here. Now, I understand from Al that your present sleigh has seen better days. Is that right?
Well, actually, I think it's holding up rather well.
Uh-huh, uh-huh. Is that good enough for you, Santa? Is a sleigh that's merely holding up rather well good enough for Father Christmas? I don't think so. No, I think you deserve better than that. I mean, my grandmother is holding up rather well. But I'm not about to load her up with toys and fly around the world. Do you understand what I'm saying, Santa? We cannot have Kris Kringle riding around in an old jalopy. I mean, what is this? Chitty chitty bang bang? Come on, how's that gonna look? People hear something rattling overhead, they look up, and they see a rusted out old sleigh bumping along, paint chipping off and backfiring. And I tell you, that's not my idea of Santa. No, sir. My Santa Claus rides in a brand new, shiny, fully loaded rocket sleigh.
Rocket sleigh?
It's the top of the line, Santa. It's the Cadillac of sleighs. And you deserve nothing but the best. Look, see what it's got here. It's got disc brakes, power steering, a sound system like you wouldn't believe, air conditioning. All right, you're not going to need the air conditioning. And it's got a wide base so that you won't tip over when you land on those slanting roofs. And it's got a keyless entry system.
Keyless entry system?
That's right.
But it doesn't have any doors.
Exactly!
Well, it looks very nice.
And you know what, Santa? I haven't even mentioned the most impressive feature of this sleigh.
What's that?
You don't need the reindeer.
What?
Not so much as an antler. This baby is self-powered. It will go from zero to Mark 3 in just 20 seconds. I mean, you hitch the reindeer to the front of this machine, they'll be getting a sleigh wedgie.
Well, Mr. Flapdoodle.
Lou, call me Lou.
Well, Lou, I can't have a sleigh with no reindeer. My reindeer wait all year for this trip. The boys and girls love the reindeer, right? They leave carrots out for them every Christmas Eve.
Well, now they could leave out a can of transmission fluid. What's the difference?
Well, I'm sorry, but if the reindeer can't be involved, then I'm afraid I have no use for it.
Whoa, hold on a second. Hold on a second. I mean, if that's going to be a deal breaker, then we can work around it. I mean, who says you have to engage the engine? If you don't want to use it, don't use it. Let the reindeer pull the sleigh if that's what you want. You're still going to get a smoother ride, softer landings, and a roomy interior. And hey, Unless I miss my guess, a gentleman of your exaggerated dimensions is gonna need plenty of room, you know what I'm saying?
Well, thank you for pointing that out, Blue. But I think I'll just stick with my old sleigh.
Look, do me a favor, will you, Santa? Do me a favor. At least, take a test drive. Will you do that for me?
No, I'm afraid I don't have time.
It's parked right outside. The engine's running. Do you hear it?
No, I don't.
Of course you don't. That's how quiet it is.
Look, I'm sorry, but I have to drop in on choir practice right now.
Well, no problem. I can wait. I'll be right here when you get back.
Well, I don't know how long I'll be gone.
Well, that's okay. I've got no place to be.
Well, choir practice could take a while.
Take all the time you need. I'll just read a periodical.
Lou, can't you tell that I am trying to get rid of you?
I sure can. I hear that every day.
And yet you insist on staying.
Unbelievable, isn't it?
All right, I'll tell you what. Why don't you come with me near the choir?
Choir, huh? They're going to be singing?
Yeah, it's a choir.
Okay, tell me this. If I come with you to hear the choir, will you take a test drive afterwards?
If I have time, we'll talk about it.
Talk about it or do it? I mean, we could talk about it all day long, but you're not going to experience the beauty of this machine until you sit your size 48 stocking in the driver's seat.
Fine. I'll take a test drive after we hear the choir.
Right. What are we waiting for?
Good. As a matter of fact, I'd like to get an outsider's opinion on the choir.
Well, I'm your man, then.
Well, do you sing?
Do I sing? Does Peter Pan scuba dive?
No.
Exactly!
Helping Bozidar with something.
With what?
Well, he's stocking up on eggnog. He doesn't want to run low over the holidays.
Is that right, Bozidar?
I am glowless.
Never mind, just help me set up these chairs.
Oh, Kit, I'd like you to meet someone. This is Lou Flapdoodle. He's a sleigh salesman from Detroit.
Nice to meet you.
Flapdoodle?
That's right.
Why am I not
everyone. Everyone have a seat now. There we go. Okay, come on, Alice. Let's go. Move it, move it. Mark, mark. Choir's gonna do its thing.
Choir's gonna do its thing.
Santa wants to hear it sing.
Santa wants to hear it sing.
Sound off.
One, two.
Sound off.
Three, four.
Sound off.
One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four.
There we go. That's it. Very good. Thank you. Okay, Santa, they're all yours.
Thank you. Well, we're here this morning to hear how the choir's progressing. Now, as most of you know, the choir performs every year at the Christmas Eve wrap party. It's the highlight of the Christmas season here at the North Pole, and we all look forward to it very much. And this morning, we're lucky enough to have two visitors who can also lend an ear, Kit Bishop and Lou Flapdoodle.
National Sleigh Company, if it runs on snow, we make it go. If it runs on gas, you can kiss
my... Oh, thank you! Thank you! Whoa! Thank you. Okay, choir, I'll turn the floor over to you now. Let's hear how it's going. Don't think we've ever heard anything quite like it. You may all return to work now and continue with your practice. And you may want to think about practicing right through lunch. Thank you. I look forward to seeing you all again on Christmas Eve. Any comments?
Well, I'm tone deaf, but it sounded good to me.
Any skilled comments?
Well, Santa, it sounded a tad rough.
A tad rough? I've heard nicer sounds come out of a whoopee cushion.
Uh-huh. Well, afraid I have to agree with Kit. I'm going to have to find someone to take over as choir master, and the sooner the better. Kit, you're it.
What?
Well, you're a music lover, aren't you? You're a singer. You would certainly know more about it than any of us. So you're the new choir master, and you can take over immediately.
Oh, no, wait a minute. I don't even work here.
Yes, you do. You're the choir master.
But I didn't agree to it.
Didn't agree to it? Phooey.
Oh, yes, Santa!
No, Phooey, not you. I'm sorry. Kit, I don't ask people to agree to the jobs I assign. If I ran the North Pole like that, we'd still be waiting for the first hula hoop to roll off the assembly line. No, I prefer to take the bull by the horns and make those decisions on my own. Now, you get over to that rehearsal hall and whip that choir into shape.
But what if I'm not good enough?
Not good enough? Oh, fiddlesticks!
Yeah, Santa?
No, I didn't mean you fiddlesticks. I was... Never mind. Now, what do you mean, not good enough?
Well, what if I can't pull it off? What if I fail?
Well, you'll never know unless you try now, will you?
What kind of encouragement is that? You're supposed to tell me that I'm good enough.
No, you're supposed to show me that you're good enough.
There you go again. That is not helping.
Just go and give it a try. If you succeed, wonderful. If you fail, well, the wrap party's ruined, and we all have a horrible Christmas. I'm kidding. Go, you'll be fine. Luke, you come with me. Let's see what that sleigh of yours can do.
You bet, Santa.
Right. The rest of you, back to work. We've only got 2 days until Christmas Eve.
Okay. Hey, you're sure this glue formula will work, huh?
Yeah, just do exactly what I wrote down.
Okay, Bozidar, let's get the rest of the supplies and get over there. Oh, and we'll need to get some eggnog, too.
Eggnog? Why?
Well, because I told Santa Claus we were getting eggnog. Do you think I'm going to lie to the big wheel?
The what?
The big wheel, the big cheese, Santa Claus.
Santa Claus is big wheel.
He's the biggest. Now go.
Goodbye, Mr. Kidney Stone.
I have all your names and I know where you live.
What's right and what's wrong, and you do that because you care. If I didn't love the elves, it wouldn't matter to me what they did.
Oh,
yes, and don't you worry. I'm sure your mother feels very lucky to have a daughter like you. And your sister's lucky, too. I never had a sister. I always wanted one. It was lonely growing up.
How did you know I had a sister?
I read her letter.
You what?
Well, I was dusting Santa's desk, and the letter was there, and I had to pick it up to move it, and I accidentally read some of it.
Oh,
your sister sounds so sweet. There's not many children who would be unselfish enough at Christmas time to want to ask for some Christmas spirit for their sister.
What?
Oh, in her letter, that's what she asked for. Oh, you didn't know? Oh.